Well, I heard back from the Bamfords Register about this engine now. I sent them off the serial number, which should be 5 digits, 56773, but it has in fact got 011 first. Well, I found out that the engine was supplied as a batch of 25 to Benfords on the 24th of February 1946, so it's possible that 011 is the batch number, but I'm not sure. Benfords, that obviously confirms that it was in a cement mixer. So yeah, it's 65 years old. I've just got another coat of varnish on the trolley, I'll just show you. Looking quite shiny now, so what I'm going to do is drag the engine outside, try and chop the board up, and then we'll shift it over later. But I've got to put the wheels on the new trolley first. So we'll chop this up, drop the wheels off, and then see where we can go from there. Well, here's the new engine trolley with the wheels bolted on. I've gone to great lengths to make sure this would be level, but unfortunately it's still about 9mm out either end. But it's not too bad. So I'll have to think carefully about how I put the engine on so as not to flood the carb, because that making sure it's level is very important, otherwise you'll find fuels coming out the intake and all sorts, so could be a bit careful. Got a chain to pull it along by, some bolts there already, bolt the engine down. Surprisingly heavy this. That's the back axle, three coach bolts. The front can only have two, which are in the middle. A bit concerned about not being strong enough, so I might at some stage put another couple through there, but haven't got enough for now, so it'll have to do for today. But yeah, I think it should be strong enough. We'll raise the engine up quite nicely. Just had three coats of varnish, which I deemed to be enough. Normally do four, but it looked plenty good enough, so decided to stick with that. Engine's all chopped up and ready to move over now. So yeah, hopefully lift it onto the trolley. Having spent considerable time cleaning the spec plate here, made a bit of a discovery. Now, I thought the serial number was 011-56773, but that is actually an OH, which I couldn't see before I cleaned it. So that, I assume, means it's been overhauled, which would explain why mechanically it's in such good condition. That might also explain the later magneto, 1957. The engine was 1946, so I assume the old one failed at some point. So I think it would have been probably a Wyco A with an impulse, which would have been nice. A much better magneto, but this one's got a cracking spark, so it seems alright. So there we are, another little discovery. The other thing I've discovered is that lots of gaskets underneath the carburetor, which probably means it's warped, but that's quite a known fault with those, so I shan't touch that for now. Well, here we are, all on its new trolley now. Ready to rally, really. This engine weighs about 160 kilos, and it was really as much as Dad and I could lift. So, you know, pretty heavy. There's plenty of room for the starting handle. Plenty of clearance. Quite easy to swing with it higher up. Lots of compression. Something else you can see evidence of here. The original silver paint on the flywheels. That was a Bamford thing. To paint them silver. I spent a long time going around with the oily rag today, and it's really picking up a nice look. Still needs a bit more, but yeah, it's getting there. But I'm really happy with the way it looks now. It's quite a tall engine, really. Compared to this, the Lister D only comes to about there, so it's quite a bit taller. I'm going to, as soon as possible, replace these nasty modern zinc studding. I'm going to replace these with nice proper half inch bolts like it should be. As soon as I can get some, I will. So I think that's it for the moment. Obviously got this leaky fuel tank to fix, just weeps slightly from there. Could run all day before it would drip, but really need to sort that. I'm pretty certain the carb's warped, like I said, because of the two gaskets in there. So I might try and get emery board and just flatten that off a bit. Really and truly need a new exhaust, I think, but that'll kind of spoil the look, so I don't know. I think we'll keep it like that. So, yeah, a few jobs to do, but pretty much there. I'm not going to run it today. It's nearly dinner time, so have to be another day now. But there we are. Hope you like it. And I'll include a few photos and things. Yeah, so thanks for watching.